She'll do everything. All you need to do is what? Show some appreciation, show some kindness, give some kind words, do something spontaneous. If you've been married a while, come on, people. We have to learn. Don't do the same thing for 10, 20, 30, 40 years. Do something different. Try something new. Surprise, surprise, surprise. Can I help you? Love is full of surprises. So that means I need to take time to find out what it is that my spouse likes, what it is that they like. So what? I can surprise them, right? Don't just wait for a special occasion, but what? Surprise them and let them know, you know what? I love you. I want you to know that I love you. So guess what happens? When that is done, it brings what? A reciprocation. Now the house is full of love. Then guess what? The children feel the love. The manifestation of love grows in your house. I love my parents' relationships. My parents were married for 38 years before my mom recently passed away. And my mom and dad showed love all the time. It was amazing. I could sit there as a child and see my dad walk in the door for no reason, bring peach roses, because that was my mom's favorite color. Peach roses, he would come in some days with candy. He'd come in, just little, you know, gifts, little stuff. Wasn't that he had to spend thousands of dollars? He would just come in and say, I love you. My mom was always cooking. She was always surprising him. Guess what? I bought you this. I bought you that. They'd go on surprise weekend getaways. We had to be, you know, go to our aunts and uncles' house so they can get away, because they kept the romance alive for 38 years. They did that. They never ceased that relationship. They kept that alive in the household so that we were able to see what real love looked like. Sometimes people will think, you know what? You don't have to do all of that. Well, when you experience what love really is, guess what happens? You will understand another mechanism of how God will begin to unveil who He is. There was no way that God could die on a cross for people that He didn't know unless He loved them. Come on. There was no way. Amen. So God did something so awesome for us. He exemplified unconditional love. Can you give that same kind of love? Can you release that same kind of love? Can you operate in that same kind of love? Can you be willing to give of yourself? Because love gives. I'm going to tell you that again. Love does what? It gives. It releases of yourself. It takes time to say, you know what? I'm not going to stop. I'm going to make sure that I invest in what I'm connected to. So don't let go. Don't give up. Remember, love is patient. Love is kind. Love is enduring. Love is long-suffering. So what? Go through the process. Right? Let me tell you something else. When it comes to love relationships, the first 5 years are rough. I want to be honest with you. Why? Because you're getting to know each other, right? The first 5 years, you're getting to learn each other. The first 5 years, you don't know each other. You're trying to build the covenant. So you have to learn what the likes, what are the dislikes, what's good, what's bad. Come on. You have to learn. Do we like Colgate or do we like Crest? Come on. You have to learn. Do they want a hamper or do they want the clothes in the laundry room? You have to learn so much about each other. You have to learn, right? And so all of those things that you did in dating, you transition now into a covenant. And so you have to agree. You have to build an agreement. So I want to tell you, that's why I said love is patient. There must be an agreement that manifests on your behalf. If you endure, you'll reap. Oh my God. If you can endure in love, you will reap. You will be so blessed. You'll be blessed beyond measure. Because why? You will understand that God has given you a person that you have the opportunity to bring out the best in. You have an opportunity to bring out the best in that person if you allow them to shine. Come on. And how are you going to allow them to shine? By loving them. You allow them to shine by releasing the love of God out of your heart. Because if I say that I love God, then I also should love my spouse, right? If I say that I love God and I give myself and I love God whom I've never seen before, how much more should I love the one who I see? How much more should I love the one that I wake up with every day? How much more should I love and give of myself so that God is going to honor you? Hear me. God honors love. Oh my goodness. Why does God honor love? Because God is love. This same passage of scripture, it says that people can speak in tongues, people can, you know, prophesy, they can do all those things. But it says, if you don't have love, wow. Come on, people of God. If I don't have love, you mean to tell me that if I don't have love, I have nothing. If I don't have love, then I'm not in the proper position to be able to function in the capacity that God called me to function in. So guess what? I can't even know God if I don't learn how to love. Come on, I can't even come into communication and relationship with God if I don't know how to love. Can I tell you today, some of you have even been broken. Some of you have been hurt, right? You know, some of you say, you know what? This person treated me that way. This person did that. The Bible says that love is not easily provoked. Come on, somebody. And it says that what? Love thinketh no evil. So even though things may happen, you have to now bring in your mentality to say, you know what? I'm not going to think evil of them. I'm not even going to allow them to provoke me. I'm going to continue to sow the seed of love. I'm going to continue, why? To pour out love, because I know if I continue to operate in love, I'm going to receive the manifestation of the thing that God wants to orchestrate in my life. So love, amen, is awesome. Love is one of the greatest things that you can do in your life. Love. Please, women and men of God, people of God, learn how to love. When you learn how to love, amen, and you love properly, love is a beautiful thing. I'm going to say that again. Love is a beautiful thing. So don't allow love to, amen, be die or love to, amen, grow cold. The Bible says there's even, amen, a place where love grows cold. Amen. Hallelujah. Don't let that be your portion. Don't let love grow cold in your life. Don't allow your heart to be, amen, hardened by a situation or something that happens. You got to learn how to say, you know what? No, I'm going to love. Why? Because love, look at what it says, it's not easily provoked. Love thinketh no evil. Look what it says. And love doesn't even rejoice in iniquity. So that means I have to learn how to overcome those places. I have to learn how to give of myself even when I don't want to. Come on. I have to learn how to supersede, amen, the things or emotions or feelings sometimes that I may feel in the natural sense to say, you know what? I made a conscious decision. I made a choice to love. Who am I talking to on today that is making a choice to love? I'm talking to men. I'm talking to women. I'm talking to those of you that are married, and I'm talking to those of you that are single. You need to learn how to love today. You need to go and, amen, ask God to help you go back and search and check your love walk. Maybe you left some places, some gaps, some holes. Maybe you didn't love like you were supposed to. Maybe you're complaining and grumbling and saying, you know what, I wish this and I wish that. Go back and check your love walk. Go back and see, have I done what I needed to do? Go back and say, you know what, I'm going to be patient. I'm going to be kind. I'm going to turn this thing around. Why? Because love has the capability to change anything. Love has the capability to change anything. On today, we want to pray for each and every one of you, because I know that there's somebody out there, amen, that may already be married, or even some that want to get married. And you say, you know what? I don't know about this love thing. I want to pray today that God will touch your heart, that you transition to learn how to love. Father, I pray in the name of Jesus that you will touch your people today. Touch your men, touch your women, touch your young adults, God. Touch your older couples, God. I pray that you begin to touch them and transition them like never before. Bring them, oh God, into a place of love. For Lord, you are love. God, you said you are love. And you said above all things that we must love. I ask, Father, in the name of Jesus, that you will do it now. Amen and amen. Well, this is the end of our show. We've made it through another segment of Deborah's Voice, and we thank God for what he has done and what he's going to do. Please tune in again as we're going to continue to talk about some more powerful subjects. This is your host, Apostle Dr. Dewan Jackson. God bless.